In this film, it's not just that a person wakes up in a room and finds himself in perilous danger. It's a situation where five people wake up and find themselves in horrible danger and then have to move from room to room.
We think it is survival of the fittest. We have these five people, because it's all five, and we think it's going to work down to just one person.
This is like a multiplayer event, if you like. It takes some cooperation, willing or not, to get through these traps.
It's not just about, you know, is this person gonna live or die? It's more about who's gonna go.
We don't want to telegraph the fact that they all needed to work together. We wanted to make sure that no viewer would look at this early on and say, well, you can see right there that they just need to simply, you know, cooperate with each other.
Get a clue, you fucking bitches! Survival of the fittest!
It seems like the more Saw films we make, the more difficult it becomes because, I mean, there are really only so many ways you can kill a person.
My favorite trap is the one that I'm not in. Because you know what happens then, right?
But I implore you.
They wake up in the first room and find collars around their necks that are attached to cables. The cables run back through pulleys against the wall and run to a common winch at the end of the room. If, for some reason, they don't make it through this trap, the winch will go off at 60 seconds, and they'll all be pulled into the V-blades that are up against the wall and be decapitated.
But because we're all linked together, we have to work together. But we're all very narcissistic. Oops.
Fuck all of you in your fucking clan!
The first room went through many variations. It started off actually really small, really easy. This is what we're gonna do. And then as the prep process started, it got bigger and bigger and bigger.
We originally thought that we could have five individual blades on their necks, but it would not have given them the peril of having to fight for the key and fight each other against the blade.
Freak me out, dude.
We went through three or four different versions of what those blades should be. We finally decided with a V-grooved blade, which works quite nicely for Saw 5.
Oh my God.
This is the winch that our victims are attached to. We do a lot of research just on the internet looking for interesting elements. We found this as the crane on the dock of a shipyard. These are the collars that our victims are attached to. They're leather and steel. Inside, of course, they're padded because our actors would start chafing after a while. They're attached to 1/8-inch aircraft cable.
The rigging process for us is to have the cables out through the wall into a pulley system. The actors have the mechanical advantage, which means they can take the weight themselves. So at the same time, the gag gets sold because you sell the tension on the line.
Effects almost puppeteer the people back and forth with the cables because the point is they're all supposed to be interconnected.
And it's beautiful, it's a ballet. Like one person can go forward, another person can't.
I would say, you know, with those dog collars on and the pulleys and all of that, that was really intense. It was a very intense day.
Everyone's very mercenary and unfortunately, I don't quite make it in time.
So this was the head that we used after Ashley gets her head cut off. It's a pretty good likeness of her. It's another sick Saw prop.
The decapitated body was extraordinary.
I always like to use real bodies as opposed to making fake bodies. I always find fake bodies don't look quite right. So we buried the body double's head into the wall and built a stump prosthetic that just laid onto her shoulders.
We've got, you know, the mead and the vertebrae and all that stuff, and her head fit in here. And this is where her real neck would be, and then the wall was right here. Tubing here is for the blood, because we had, well, Saw, we use a lot of blood, and we had it pumping out and flowing out of the neck stump.
Has to be very quick so she can go into the wall and out of the wall because it's quite uncomfortable. Some of the people weren't aware that it was a real body in there and they were a little bit freaked out when the body was moving.
So we walked in and we saw this what looked like a dummy. So when I looked at it, I went, that's fantastic. It looks so real. And then it moved. Oh my God.
That is a fucked up. Oh my God, look at her head.
I can't believe
that's
that.
That's crazy.
You see the body and you see her breathe and you're like,
who is that? Is someone doing that?
It's freaking me out.
No, seriously, that's a person's body. I know, because someone's... No, there's no way. There's no way someone's moving like that.
Yeah, I'm sure I'll be dreaming about it for the next 25 years, but that's all right.
After I do this... And
that's freaking me out.
Shoe, no.
The second trap is kind of a musical chairs situation. We have four chambers in the walls. that four people could potentially escape into, but Jigsaw has only left them three keys somewhere up above.
Jars above me are made of candy glass, really delicate. Any touch of them, they'll shatter. Inside them, we have more candy glass, but they're safe for actors.
Let's do this fucking thing, Mark.
And action!
They begin smashing the jars, glass rains down on everybody.
As soon as these are all gone, it's a free fall.
And they have to crawl around on their hands and knees in the broken glass and try to find the keys.
Each lock is not just a regular lock, because it's a Jigsaw world. So they end up being shaped, so we had to make custom locks and custom keys.
The great thing about the sensibilities of these traps is that they're multi-layered. There's the thing that's going on, but there's also the fact that there's a bomb in a room full of nasty-looking rusty nails. Which no one wants to be impaled by nasty-looking rusty nails.
This bomb was first designed for Saw 3. They're just big jars with a lot of nails and some plasticine.
We're doing a fake bomb blast, which will be air cans and debris. To look like that as the characters move to the next room, the bomb behind them goes off.
Unfortunately, as I know, Charles doesn't make it.
Wait!
These body parts are Carlos. We did not mold the actor for this piece. It was so disfigured that we didn't necessarily need the exact actor for this. This isn't fully dressed yet, obviously. We're gonna dress it in on the set, put nails in it, spread blood on it, freshen it up.
That guy was an asshole, but he was smart. I could've used him.